If a patient experiences any sensation of irregular pulse rhythm, the single best advice I can give them is to obtain an EKG. An EKG during the arrhythmia or the symptoms is the gold standard to document exactly what this is. This is not always feasible if the symptoms are fleeting, lasting only seconds to minutes, but in the event of longer standing palpitations, an EKG, where they simply place electrodes in the chest, takes less than 2 minutes, would be the definitive diagnosis for atrial fibrillation. The critical step is to make the diagnosis earlier rather than later, such that potentially important decisions can be made to avoid downstream complications. When someone has atrial fibrillation, there are a couple very simple tests that usually are needed upon the diagnosis. The first would be some basic lab work. Classically, excess thyroid hormone can cause atrial fibrillation, so it's important to rule that out with a simple laboratory test. The second test that's essential is an ultrasound of the heart, also called an echocardiogram. It's similar to when looking for the baby in the belly, except they put a probe on the chest and actually see the heart squeeze. That allows you to look at the function of the heart and the valvular performance of the heart. Sometimes valvular problems can actually trigger atrial fibrillation. So those two things, which can be performed in very short order, would be the kind of the bare minimum workup to get the process going with atrial fibrillation.